Authentic control. Yes. Authentic control. Steel Empire. I played this game. It's all right. This game's okay. Yeah, this is one of those rare shoot 'em ups that doesn't take away your power ups when you die. It's noteworthy just for that alone. So rare. Somewhere, sometime, in a world almost familiar, it is the age of steel mammoth battleships. Cruise the skies. That sentence doesn't make any sense. Armored locomotives carry cannons the size of railway cars. Invincible fortresses float in the air. Military might rules the day. The Motorhead Empire has conquered and enslaved virtually the entire planet. Yet one hope for freedom still remains, the Republic of Silverhead. They alone have the will to survive. They alone can turn back the Motorhead's military machine. They alone have the weapons to achieve victory. Their missile-firing Striker airplane has front and rear air-to-ground armor-piercing missiles. Their Zeppelin airship carries an aerial mine launcher. Their devastating lightning bomb will reduce Motorhead's multi-gun turreted flame-shooting juggernauts into crumbling hulks of molten metal. So lest freedom perish and evil prepare, save Silverhead, climb aboard the most fantastic aircraft ever created, and wage the War of the Steel Empire. So you get more lives but less continues. Weird. The level you choose affects both the speed and intensity of the gameplay. Okay. Reallocate buttons, sound test. Fire left, fire right, lightning bomb. Yes, right. There's like an airplane and a zeppelin you can fly. The zeppelin's like better taking out ground targets, I guess. Something like that. Striker airplane has speed, quickness, front and rear firing missiles, and front and rear air-to-ground armor-piercing missiles. Its maximum effectiveness is achieved in limited airspace or against large numbers of opponents. The zeppelin, solid, resilient, armed with front and rear firing missiles, front and rear upward firing aerial mines. The Z-01 is the pride of the Republic against even the biggest behemoths of the Motorhead Empire. Its record staggers belief. You can change aircraft between every level of the game, adjusting your selection according to the type of enemy ships to be faced, terrain negotiated. Yeah. Yeah, I'm not using any free flushes until we get to the Amiga. Which means we're going to be in Genesis for a while. Because it keeps giving me fucking, like, unbeatable games. Every 3 experience points you collect upgrades your level by 1. Your maximum of 20 upgrade levels. Line City of Rawl, the Leidengill Caverns, Sky District, Zektor, Gardandi Beach, Dama City, Gurmburn Fortress, Lunar Space, 7 levels. I think this game is like a remake, too, on Steam, doesn't it? Yeah, I finished Dick Tracy, somehow. Barely. Right, let's play some Steel Empire. There are no Kid Amiga games on board. This game did steampunk before steampunk was cool. Flickering is hurting my eyes, though. You can reduce them, but you can't increase them. It was based on a TV show. The cop game. I remember the one you're talking about. Motorhead Empire's never been to something. Till now. No, the flickering is intended dash. It's supposed to be like an old movie reel. If it was a bug, the text would be flickering too. Game doesn't do that though.
Good luck.
At least better not. Nice thing about being a Twitch partner, then they get transcode options for everybody, so I can stream at a high quality, and you know, people have low internet, they can just lower the quality themselves. That's why I stream at 1080p 60fps, even though I don't really need to for these games. There's no reason not to. Just show up with a health bar, and you don't lose your health and your power-ups when you die. Thank you. I mean, if you're running it at native resolution and you wanted the pixels to look correct, you'd have to run the game in like a little postage stamp on your monitor. Unless you have a 320 by 200 monitor. Happening when I run it at a high resolution. It's just integer scaling. That's a big gun. Oh, I remember this. Yeah, the neck of the cannon. Threw it up to him. Jabby. Integer scaling, not scanning. Scale. Let's make it like you're watching a projector in like an old 1930s film reel thing. That's what they were trying to do. It's just really annoying. Darkness effect looks like on a CRT, like dithering to simulate darkness. It just looks dark and gloomy. Actually, it looks kind of better. Oh god. Yeah, I just turned on a CRT filter. Some health here. Yes, we can shut it off. Just wanted to see what the darkness was supposed to look like. Yes, health. Health. That's easy to get health. Holy fuck. Ah! No, I've never been a game programmer. I took programming in college because I wanted to make games, but I never actually did it. Because the game industry sucks. It's like a career choice. It's a terrible career path. College. Out of high school, you know? I was like 18, 19. But then you look into actual game jobs and how shitty that industry is, and it's just like, never mind. I'll just play games and program boring business software. Slow down. Oh.
Oh.
When in doubt, smart ball. Hey, so happy new year. Changed up his firing pattern, you asshole. Supposed to hit it now. It's just on the top of it somewhere. Yeesh. That was a... Oh. God damn it. Fucking Christ. This is really hard with no health. Whoa, what the fuck? So I have to hit his tiny little periscope while I'm trying to dodge his missiles. That's great. Surface now? Well, what's going on in the background there? That must be an emulation glitch. like shooting like ninja stars at me or something. Anybody has ever asked what the story is in a shoot 'em up, though. Congratulations. You have an internet first. It's just, I've never heard of somebody caring what the story is in a shmup. There's things to shoot, go shoot them. That's the story. Saxo, happy new year, man.
Good luck.
Stage 5. I think the menu said 7 stages, right? We are in outer space now. Okay. We weren't in space, we were just really high up. Ow! Fuck! Oh no. Already out of health.
Thank you.
Level 19, we're almost fully upgraded now.
Whoa! Oh, fuck.
The exact same battleship we caught earlier. I just rammed into it and lost all my health. Good job. lightning thing was lame. Huh? We have an amp here. What the? Yeah, he said he was gonna be playing that. It's definitely one of those "why does this game exist?" games. Some Japanese game on PS2. I don't remember what it's called. Which is why a helicopter and have to take pictures of giant, like, 500 foot tall bikini clad women. It's real bad. Just instantly into the mission. If you're at the point where you have to, like, recycle all your bosses, maybe your game's too long. It's time to cut a level or two. What does this thing need to have? Not much help, apparently. Hey, Bumpy Mink. That was both my plan. Big gun. Or pipe. Guess we're going in. Obstacle course levels and shoot 'em ups. Remember what the game used to give health power-ups? That was pretty sweet. If Princess Maker 5 exists, because Princess Maker 1 through 4 is old enough to make more of them. That's why. Health! Health! Give me that! No! 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 Oh, I got it. Okay. another recycled bomb. There's the bottom of it, finally. Are we gonna get shot out of this giant cannon into space or something? Ride the giant bullet! Stage 7.
3, 2, 1, 0.
Oh, excuse me. Space! Man, the slowdown is actually, like, really helpful for dodging this shit. I'm glad this game has as much slowdown as it does. It would actually be harder without it. I wonder if the remake on Steam, like, has, like, hard-coded slowdown in, or if you just have to be a ninja. This without the slowdown would be really tough. Oh god. Alright, thank you for gifting sub to Doomsday. Pretty much, man. Enjoy your emote to Doomsday. Losing all my health here. Stop it. Oh, there's too many bullets. There's too many. Too many. Bombs and ass. remains at. I hope that was the end boss, because I just used all my bombs on him. Seemed end bossy. Yep, there we go. Victory! That's it. That's the ending. Yay, we actually finished something today other than fucking Pocahontas. Pocahontas, a really nice pixel art. Not much of a video game, though. What? Weird.
20th something.
I think it's just gibberish to try and look like the end of a movie credit. I don't think it actually says anything. First place. Damn. That's pretty rare. When you finish a game and don't get first place on the built-in leaderboard. That's very rare. Steel Empire. Red 5. Up notable for having an actual reasonable level of difficulty compared to the most. All right. What is next? Oh, yeah, I'm going to reduce the count.